All right, in this video, let's talk about impossible array formulas that are actually possible in Google Sheets and Excel. You should be able to do this in Google Sheets currently if you have current version 365 or hopefully whatever version it is at some point that has these functions. You should be able to use these right away. With array formulas, we end up using them more in Google Sheets. Mostly that's because in Google Sheets, there is really no good way to kind of copy a formula down automatically in the column. For that reason, you end up creating this array formulas in Google Sheets just to get the dragging the formula down effect. In Excel, since we have tables, we don't need to do those all that much, even though they could be useful at times as well. But with all of that said, in this video, I don't want you to concentrate on particular formulas. We're just going to understand the fact that we could take any formula that previously could not be converted to array formulas and now convert it to an array formula. Let's just create a simple formula like that. So for example, let's say I want to do some sort of if statement. And here I'm going to do some sort of AND function within this if statement. And I'm going to check for a couple of conditions. So for example, I'm going to check if this number is greater than 7,000, comma. And at the same time, let's say I want to make sure that this region equals Midwest. So I'm going to close this AND function, comma, and then I need value if true, value if false. So I'm just going to keep this simple. I'm just going to say yes or no, like so. So this is going to be my function. If you are familiar with AND functions, then you know that AND functions don't work with array formulas. So right now, I can drag this down the regular way, and you should be able to see in this line when it's Midwest and it's above 7,000, we get a yes. For all these other lines, we get a no because we don't have both conditions that match. Now, if I just make up another one here, let's make this above 7,000. Now, this is a yes too, and this is a yes. So you can see how this works, but this is not an array formula. And if we try to convert it to an array formula, and in Google Sheets, we're going to have to do Control-Shift-Enter or Command-Shift-Enter to do this as an array formula. And usually you would do something like this, go over this range of data, however far you want this to go, that's up to you. Something like this. So if I'd enter, this is not going to work. As you can see, I just get a no, it doesn't actually fill the array. And in Excel, it would have been the same thing, except that in Excel, we wouldn't have this array formula wrapper. So if I just copy this, go to my Excel spreadsheet here, I do equals, I paste that same formula I just did there, I hit enter, see, it still doesn't work because AND function does not handle arrays. So how do we make this work? So what we can do, we can go back here and I'm going to just go back to not an array formula, like this. This is what my formula was, and I should be able to drag this down. As you can see, get my results. And it's possible that you want this to also work if you go to this extra lines. So right now it says no. So what we could do, we could add like an extra handling here. Instead of if, we could say ifs here. And then here, I could check if this equals blank. So I'm going to say if that is blank, let's say there is no region, then let's say we're going to return a blank, comma. If this sales amount equals blank, then we're going to return a blank, comma. And then I went over these two cases. So if they're not blanks, both, then we can do this. So we can say, if it's going to meet both of those conditions, we're going to say yes. And we need otherwise case here because this is ifs function. So we'll do true and we'll say no, something like this. So yet again, I want you to think less about this particular formula itself. We want to concentrate on the fact that this formula cannot be converted to an array formula by default. Now, let's take this and make it an array formula. So I'm just going to copy this function without equal sign. And then I'm going to go here and I'm going to use map function. Now, to truly understand what I'm going to do here, you really need to understand lambda function. And I have a separate video. It's not really that simple. Lambda function is pretty difficult to actually understand. So I really recommend to really watch lambda function videos. I've also done map and lambda videos. But for now, see, this map function is going to accept array. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to just select this list of sales amounts. Let's move this, comma. And then if we need more arrays in this, more columns of data in our case, we will also select this one. So these used to be the two columns I used to use in my formula, if you remember. So I'm going to select those two ranges, do a comma. And then the third here could be another array if you have more arrays to include here. I don't. So then the last one is going to be a lambda function. And in this lambda function, we're going to create parameters. And those parameters are going to be our values from this first array and the second array. And if you have more arrays, third array, fourth array, etc. If you have just one array, it would be just one parameter. So for example, this first column of values for my case in F column, I'm just going to call them sales. This is just a variable name. You can call it whatever you want, comma. And then all of these values, which is the D column, I'm going to call it region, just like this, comma. And then once you're done with naming all of these parameters, which are going to be all the values coming from those arrays, you basically just paste your function as the calculation. So I'm just going to paste that entire thing I had before right here, which is pretty long. So it's going to go over to the next line, which is fine. And then finally, we need to close the lambda function and we need to close that map function like this. So now we need to make some changes inside of this inner function that I just pasted in here. And basically what we want to do, we want to just replace the values. Right now, for example, like this one is D2, right? So D refers to regions. So for that reason, I'm just going to replace it with region, which is this variable I just made here. Then this F2, which is one of the sales, refers to sales. And then again, I have F2 again here, which is this. So that would be sales. And then I have D2 here, which is region, and that will be region, just like that. So essentially what's going to happen in this array function, it's going to take this range of values, and for each line from that range, it's going to basically use the sales variable as the value in that line. And then the same way for this column, which I called region here, it's going to take for each line, whatever the value is from that column, from here, from this case region, and it's going to use that value in that iteration of that loop. And now if I just take this and hit enter, you'll see how that entire thing worked as an array formula. And I ended up just having one formula that creates this entire array of values. And at this point, we could just delete this and just have one array formula that does all of this. So this same exact formula, if I copy this, should work exactly the same way in Google Sheets. So I'm going to go here and paste over here that map function, hit enter. And notice I did not have to do array formula for this in Google Sheets, like I didn't have to do that in Excel too. So it's literally exactly the same formula. And you can see how I was able to take this function that is not really something that handles array and make it work as an array formula. Now, what's also interesting about this map functions that a lot of people don't seem to understand is that when you do a map function and you do these values like sales region right here, those values become a reference, not just a value. Let me give you an example of this so you can see why that's important. Let's just label this yes, no for now. And let's just make another column here. Let's call this one running total. So if I'm trying to do something like a running total, a regular formula for this would be something like this. You would do sum, and then let's say the sales is what I want. So I would basically grab this and then do another F2 to grab that same cell. And then I would add a lock to this first row number 2 like this. And what this is going to accomplish is that if I drag this down, with every line, it's gonna keep this one 2, but this one is gonna go another line down. So now it's gonna be the total of this 2. And then if I go to the next line, it's the total of these 3 and then of these 4, right? So we have the situation where our beginning value, F2, remains the same all the time. But this one, this second part of the range, it goes to the next line down, like so. So this is a very difficult formula to convert to an array formula, but we can still do that using something like a map function. So let me give you that example. So one more time, I'm gonna go ahead and copy this function without that equal sign, hit escape, go back here, and I'm gonna do equals map, like this. And now we got this, what we call an array, right? And if you remember the range of values I was using here, the only values I was using here was pretty much this data from this column. So I'm gonna select that. So I don't have another column in this case. So I'm just gonna do a comma, which means if you don't have another column, you just move on to your lambda function. So I'm gonna do my lambda function. And here we're gonna name a parameter for this. So I'll just call this sale. You can call it anything you want. Just don't name it with your existing ranges or functions and you should be fine, comma. And then I just have one, right? So it's this range, so we name it sale. So now I'm gonna paste whatever I used to have there, that sum function. And now I need to make sure I close enough parentheses. So I need to close that lambda function and I need to close that map function like this. So at this point, if you remember what used to happen, this F2 used to remain the same all the time in all the formulas, while this part used to change to the next line down. And because this here is not a value, it's a reference, basically it's like a cell reference. So what we could do here, we could essentially just go instead of this F2 and replace it with that reference sale like this, while keeping this one as it was before. And this basically is the current row reference at this point. So in the first line, it's gonna be this amount. In the next line, it's gonna be this reference to this cell. And then it's gonna go reference to this cell. So with every line, it's the reference to that cell. So let me show you what happens when I hit enter. And you can see this actually worked, because essentially what happens, this creates that effect of our reference moving down with each line of that array, and we end up getting that new range. And now I don't need these. I could have just used that. And again, this works exactly the same way in Excel, right? So if I copy this, go back to Excel, and paste it, same thing is gonna happen. This was actually originally created in Excel before it was added to Google Sheets. So I think we should really recognize how much good stuff Excel team has done recently in our spreadsheets with some of these functions. So now with this same thing, if I go back to this, let's say you wanted to make sure this works for this range that you're pointing to. So let's say I want to extend this range instead of going from here through here. I want to go from here through here. I hit enter. That just gives us this running total, which by itself is already good, right? It just basically just adds a zero for all these lines. But if you didn't want that, maybe you want, if this is a blank, then leave it blank sort of thing. You could have done that. So we could go back here, and here instead of this, this is essentially our formula. We could have just done an if statement. I could do if that sale, which is that reference to the current row, equals blank, comma, then leave it blank, comma. Otherwise, do this sum function. And then I'm going to go after this, close parentheses, like this, hit enter. And now it would be cleaner like this. See, it's going to add until here. These are blanks, as you can see. And now if we add more numbers below, it should automatically calculate that line. And instead of a blank, it's going to give us that running total. So there you go. That's how we make impossible array formulas possible. If you like my content, make sure to like the video, subscribe, leave some comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.